同志们,
comrades,
朋友们,
friends,
全国脱贫攻坚,
National Commendation Conference on Poverty Alleviation
现在开始,
now begins.
请全体起立,
please all rise,
奏唱中华人民共和国, National Anthem. 国歌。
Please be seated.
今天, 党中央国务院,
Today, Party Central Committee,
在这里隆重举行,
State Council,
全国,
held this grand ceremony to honor the great contributors to China's poverty alleviation cause.
中共中央总书记,
With us today, we have
国家主席,
General Secretary of the CPC Central Committee and Chair of the Central Military Commission, President Xi Jinping.
中共中央政治局常委,
and members of the Standing Committee of the Political Bureau of the CPC Central Committee, Comrade Li Zhanshu, Wang Yang, Wang Huning, Zhao Leji, and Han Zheng, and Vice Premier Wang Qishan.
出席今天大会的还有党和国家其他领导者,
the other officials from party and the country, members from the Central Military Commission, and key personnel from different regions and departments, Central Committee of Democratic Parties, the Old China Federation of Industry and Commerce, and public figures without party affiliation, as well as recipients of the National Honorary Title Role Model, and part of the outstanding collectives, and also the family members of the outstanding contributors.
请中共中央,
and now, please allow me to invite member of the Standing Committee of the Political Bureau of the CPC Central Committee, Chairman of the CPPCC, Wang Yang, to read out the decision on granting national honorary title to the role models to the poverty alleviation cause.
中共中央国务院 关于授予全国脱贫攻坚楷模荣誉称号的决定,
to role models for their contribution to poverty alleviation cause. Since 18th CPC National Congress, CPC Central Committee with Comrade Xi Jinping as core has put poverty alleviation as a priority for the governments. The party has led the All Party and the people from all ethnic groups. We have taken a series of innovative measures, and we also roll out the poverty alleviation battle with the largest scale and benefiting the most population. General Secretary Xi Jinping in person provide guidance, deployment, and also offer supervision in this regard. He has made a number of important guidance and laid a solid guidance and also the principle for poverty alleviation work. With 8 years of endeavor, poverty alleviation has gained complete victory. Under current standard, almost 100 million rural poor population has been lifted out of poverty. All the poor counties removed the cap of poverty. The absolute poverty issue has been resolved. We have actually written up a miracle in the history of poverty reduction. This has also made an important contribution to build a modern prosperous society. This has also helped us to embark a new journey to build a modern socialist country. In our endeavor to fight poverty, there were a number of touching stories and outstanding individuals and role models.
Their stories showcase 和我国社会主义制度的显著优势，集中体现了中华民族扶贫济困、守望相助的传统美德和社会主义核心价值观，生动诠释了中国人民改革创新、攻坚克难的精神风貌，充分反映了共产党人不忘初心的使命担当和全心全意为人民幸福幸福的深厚情怀，感人至深，催人奋进。为隆重表彰激励先进、大力弘扬民族精神、时代精神和脱贫攻坚精神，充分激发全党全国各族人民干事创业的责任感、使命感、荣誉感，汇聚更强大的力量推进全面建设社会主义现代化国家。党中央、国务院决定授予毛湘林等十名同志、河北省塞罕坝集建林场等十个集体全国脱贫攻坚楷模
honorary title of the role model for poverty alleviation in China.
我国进入新发展阶段，贯彻新发展理念，构建新发展格局，推动高质量发展，任务艰巨，责任重大，使命光荣。党中央号召，全党全国各族人民要以习近平同志为习近平新时代中国特色社会主义思想为指导，全面贯彻党的十九大和十九届、二中、三中、四中、五中全会精神，以全国脱贫攻坚楷模为榜样，增强四个意识，坚定四个自信，做到两个维护，更加紧密地团结在以习近平同志为核心的党中央周围，不忘初心，牢记使命，开拓进取，奋发有为，为全面推进乡村振兴、巩固脱贫攻坚成果、为全面建设社会主义现代化国家、实现中华民族伟大复兴的中国梦做出新的更大贡献。宣读完毕。
现在
Now,
I would like to
invite General Secretary of the Communist Party of China Central Committee, Chinese President Xi Jinping, as well as the Chairman of the Central Military Commission, to present awards and certificates, as well as the medal to the National Honorary Title recipients.
攻坚楷模个人获得者毛向林，
毛向林，
重庆市巫山县竹贤乡
Secretary of
夏庄村
夏庄 Village Party Committee from Southwest China's Chongqing Municipality. 白晶莹，
科尔沁右翼中旗，
蒙古族
刺绣产业专项推进组组长，组长
Middle Banner People's Congress from Inner Mongolia Autonomous Region。 李玉 Academician of Chinese Academy of Engineering, Professor of Jilin Agricultural University. Secretary of a Party Branch and Principal of a Huaping Grove High School in Lijiang City, Southwest China's Yunnan Province. Researcher of Daizhuang Township Organic Specialized Cooperative from East China's Jiangsu Province. Former Research Fellow from the Bureau of Foreign Affairs of the Chinese Academy of Social Science. And the collectives.
河北省赛罕坝机械林场。
赛罕坝 Mechanical Forest Farm from North China's Hebei Province.Village of Jinzhai County from East China's Anhui Province.
夏东
Township Party Committee of Shouning County, Yujian Province.
江西省瑞金市叶平乡
Township of East China's Jiangxi Province.
Shibadong
Village from Central China's Hunan Province. From Central Village, Liangshan Yi Autonomous Prefecture, from the Southwest China's Sichuan Province. Agroelectric Work Department of Tibet Power Company Limited.
Haojiaqiao
Village from South Northwest China's Shanxi Province.
Qinghai Sheng Haidongshi. 土族自治县五十镇班彦村
Village, 五竹图 Autonomous County, Northwest China's Qinghai Province.
宁夏回族自治区永宁县闽宁镇
from Northwest China's 宁夏回 Autonomous Region.
现在请汪洋同志宣读中共中央国务院关于表彰全国脱贫攻坚先进个人和先进集团的贡献。
中共中央、国务院
CPC Central Committee State Council decision on granting honorary titles to outstanding individuals and outstanding collectives contribution to poverty alleviation cause. Since the 18th CPC National Congress, all party and people of different ethnic groups have been actively respond to the call of General Secretary Xi Jinping. They have been earnestly implement the decisions made by CPC Central Committee and State Council on poverty alleviation. They have dedicated themselves in the fight against poverty. All localities and departments have selected talents, conquered difficulties. They have provided mutual assistance in the East and the West. And also we are seeing the efforts from different sectors of the society. The party members, cadres, and the members of the public endure hardships and strive to become stronger. They have made great contributions to build a moderately prosperous society and win poverty alleviation. There are a number of touching stories and typical examples in this endeavor. In order to commend these outstanding individuals and collectives during the fight against the poverty alleviation and forge an atmosphere to encourage people from the public to learn from the outstanding individuals and collectives, the CPC Central Committee and the State Council have decided to grant honorary titles to 1,981 individuals as the name of the outstanding individual and also to grant the outstanding collective's honorary title to 1,501 collectives. We hope these people and the collective who are receiving the honorary titles to cherish the honor, work harder, and continue to play a key role, a leading role, and make contributions to the party and our people's cause. The CPC Central Committee calls on the party and people of all ethnic groups to learn from these outstanding individuals and outstanding collectives. We should learn from them to be loyal to the party and hold on to the political faith and be a practitioner in exercising Xi Jinping's thought on socialism with Chinese characteristics for the new era. We should learn from them to serve the people and bear responsibility, live up to the mission. We should always put people as our top priority and save the people wholeheartedly, so that we can improve the sense of gaining happiness achievement for our people. We should learn from their diligence, their innovative working style, and their dedication, so that we could serve the party and the people with all of our efforts. We should learn from them to sacrifice, learn from their spirit, stay true to the original aspiration, live up to the mission. We should use our passion and high morale and devote ourselves to build China into a socialist country. All party and people of different ethnic groups should be guided by Xi Jinping's thought on socialism with Chinese characteristics for the new era, implement the spirit from the 19th CPC National Congress and also the spirit from the 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th Plenary Session, strengthen for awareness, and for confidence to the two safeguards. We should rally closer around CPC Central Committee with Communist Xi Jinping at its core. We should forge ahead and work tirelessly to build China into a modern socialist country and write up a new chapter for national rejuvenation of Chinese nation.
Now, I'd like to invite the leaders on the stage to present the award
to the recipients.
Thank you. live coverage from the Great Hall of the People of a particular moment in Chinese history, the Chinese President Xi Jinping honoring the dozens, now hundreds, if not thousands of people who have met what many thought would be an impossible deadline, eradicating deep poverty in China by this year. President Xi declared a December victory. The ceremony underway, President Xi himself handing out these awards and these medals.
They're from all walks of life. Some of them are local officials, they're teachers, they're scientists, and also academicians, technologies, etc. But they have one thing in common, which is they have made great, great achievements and contributions to achieve this major victory against poverty here in China. And now today is an emotional moment for all of them, also something that they need to memorize for maybe the rest of their lives.
On the stage here, the great hall of people, including that few people outside the government get to venture into, and to not only be inside this building that is so famous across China, but also on the stage with President Xi himself handing over these awards, thanking them personally. We saw one emotional moment earlier with a 97-year-old woman who is in a wheelchair. You saw her struggle, trying to get up, wanting to greet President Xi on her feet, but her health not allow her to do that. She is a volunteer, a former researcher at the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences, and joined the Communist Party at the age of 15, and spent a good part of her life devoted to fighting poverty. So, Dr. Chu, let me bring you here into this conversation. A lot of these figures are well known in China. You recognize some of them, yes?
Yes, for many people, for many Chinese people, this is a famous name, made a principal in a walking female middle school in Yunnan province. I always get very personal and emotional when I mention her name. Probably she is the closest walking image of nearly a saint in China. If you have never known his life record of what has she done to those vulnerable young female in the rural remote areas who are trapped in the extreme poverty with no future, and how she changed and recovered those young people, you will be really touched by her. And she probably sacrificed everything she had, the health, the wealth, the time and energy and anything else, just to stuck with those poor areas, those young people. And now she changed a lot of people's future. So probably a lot of people are saying she is like a Chinese version of Sister Teresa, or like the really great volunteer in education, in gender equality, in poverty reduction. So no matter how much honor and title you put on her, I think there's no exaggeration. And she's really because of long-time arduous work in a poor area and malnutrition. She has been suffering from a very bad health condition, but she still made it to receive this honor, the well-deserved honor. I think this is really a great day. I think this image really made my day.
Just individuals, it's also organizations, it's different villages and towns that we would be honored as well for trying different ideas to lift themselves out of poverty, whether that's pursuing different farming ideas or is a new technology. So, Professor Don, when you look at this moment and look at the ground and kind of say, hey, all the people, what significant is this for the folks there?
Well, I think it's that kind of a 10 collective organizations awarded today. And I think this is one example of why do we do this, because these are ordinary people doing extraordinary things, millions of people involved in this at various levels of government, lower levels of the government.
And we are waiting now for President Xi Jinping to speak after honoring various people from all walks of life, as we mentioned, as well as community organizations and villages here. Mm-hmm. The Great Hall of the People is silent. The stage is set. President Xi will be approaching the podium any minute now to deliver his remarks and to thank the people for their service.
Now, I'd like to invite General Secretary of the Central Committee of China, Xi Jinping, Chairman of the Central Military Commission, to deliver the keynote speech.
Thank 同志们, 朋友们,
comrades, friends,
今天,
today,
我们隆重召开大会,
we held this grand ceremony to solemnly declare that with the joint effort made by the party and the people across all ethnic groups in China, as well as this crucial moment to welcome and celebrate the 100th anniversary of establishing of CPC, we have declared a complete success in fighting against poverty. Under the current standard, 98.99 million rural impoverished population have been lifted out of poverty.
832个贫困县,
832 poor counties, as well as 128,000 poor villages all removed from the poverty list.
区域性整体贫困,
the regional
得到解决,
poverty issues have been resolved. Therefore, we finished the arduous task of eradicating absolute poverty, creating another incredible miracle.
This is a great glory
for Chinese people, also the glory of the Chinese Communist Party, as well as for our Chinese nation.
在这里,
我代表党中央, here, on behalf of a Party Central Committee, to the recipients of outstanding individuals and collectors, I would like to extend warm congratulations to you all
and
to the great contributors, including the units and the companies from the party, the government and the military, as well as the grassroots organizations and the party members, cadres, general public, first secretary stationed in the villages, as well as the team members, volunteers, the members from the Democratic parties, the All China Federation of Industry and Commerce, and public figures without a party affiliation, the people organizations, as well as all of society, extend my great contribution to you. And to those who actively support China's endeavors, our compatriots from Hong Kong ICR, Macau ICR, and people from the Taiwan region, as well as overseas Chinese, and also the big thank you to the governments of other countries, international organizations from all over the world who have shown understanding and support for China's endeavor in poverty alleviation. Comrades, friends, poverty is a deep-rooted issue in a human society. Fighting against poverty has always been a big thing to do on the list for all countries throughout the times. The Chinese history also reflects our journey and history fighting against poverty. From Qiyuan's
feeling,
saying that long did I sign to hold back tears, saddened I am by the grave of my people, to the vision expressed by Du Fu, saying that where can I get a big broad shelter, a thousand, 10,000 spans wide, huge roof that all the world's poor people can share with smiling faces, and to the long-cherished wishes made by Dr. Sun Yat-sen, saying homes have adequate supplies and the people live in contentment. All these lines have reflected
丰衣足食的深深渴望
hope and wishes to get rid of the poverty and enrich people's lives.
由于封建统治的腐朽
after modern time,
和西方列强的入侵
and invasion made by Western powers,
中国政局动荡
the political situation in China was in turbulence and the war was unceasingly happening,
贫困的梦魇
making people in poverty and the nightmare of staying in poverty haunted our people.
摆脱贫困 成了中国人民孜孜以求的
had been ongoing and longing dreams for the people.
And
it's also a very important component to realize Chinese dream of national rejuvenation. Since the establishment of the Communist Party of China, we have always seeked to be a founding mission of seeking happiness for the Chinese people and rejuvenating the Chinese nation. We have
led
in solidarity to create a better life for ourselves through our long-term hard work. And during the period of the new democratic revolution, the people rallied, raised and led a vast number of farmers to divide their land from the local tyrants so that the farmers could have their own land and the poor could be liberated. By doing so, the party received endorsement and support of the people, thus winning the victory of the Chinese Revolution and establishing new China. We have laid it as a solid foundation in political condition.
新中国成立后,
after establishing the new China, the party rallied the people to complete the socialist revolution and establish a basic
推进社会主义建设,
advanced socialist
组织人民,
construction,
自力更生,
and also let the people rely on their own efforts to make great contribution to restructure our country,
为摆脱贫困,
and also
改善人民生活,
laid a solid foundation for poverty eradication and improving people's lives.
改革开放以来,
since the reform and opening up, the party also led the people to initiate a larger scale, well-planned, well-organized poverty alleviation initiative, focusing on liberating and developing productive forces, and intensifying efforts to safeguard and improve people's well-being, and also achieved an unprecedented achievement. Since the 18th National Congress of the CPC, the Party Central Committee made it very clear that building a moderately prosperous society, the most difficult and challenging part job lies in the rural areas, especially in the poverty-stricken areas. If the rural area, especially the poverty-stricken areas, not reach the well-being society, then there will be no complete socialist society in well-being manners in China. We emphasize that the poverty should not include it in socialism. If the poor region always stay poor for a long time and the outlook remained unchanged and people's living standards not significantly improved, then that's not demonstrated the advantages of a social system, which is not what we called socialism. Therefore, we should spare no time and spare no effort to do a good job in poverty alleviation.
年底,
in the end of year 2012, after
党中央,
the 18th National Congress of the CPC. The Party Central Committee emphasized that when defining a moderately prosperous society, the key is to observe the condition of farmers. So we should see that the farmers in poverty can be a better life. And we also made our commitment that we must not leave a poor area or single person in poverty behind. Therefore, we initiated and also embarked our new journey on poverty alleviation in the new era. In year 2013, the Party Central Committee also raised the concept of a targeted poverty alleviation by equipping with the fresh working mechanism. And in 2015, the Party Central Committee also organized the working conference in this front, and giving the overarching requirement on the poverty alleviation target. So in this overarching requirement is mentioned the six areas regarding the poverty alleviation targets, project arrangement, fund usage, measures to household, right people assigned to the right villages, and results of the poverty alleviation. We have also launched a series of actions regarding the production development, relocation, ecological confrontation, and also the education as well as social security. Thus, launching the order to start the a general attack on poverty. In year 2017, the 19th National Congress of the CPC
precision
poverty alleviation as one of the three tough fronts,
全面建成小康社会目标,
targeting securing a decisive victory in building a well-being society, and also security victory in poverty alleviation. In year 2020, in order to effectively cope with the impact brought by the COVID-19 pandemic, as well as the Party Central Committee required the whole party as well as the whole country with greater resolve and stronger strength to do a good job in these additional tests, and also putting a great end to our fight against poverty, and with every reason to believe that we have that confidence to march towards the final victory. 8 years on, the Party Central Committee has put the poverty alleviation in the prominent position in our country's governance, making poverty alleviation as the bottom line task to build the moderately prosperous society over specs, and initiated a massive people's war against poverty. The party and the people blazed trails, overcame obstacles, and also promoted the spirit of perseverance and brave enough to tackle the most challenging tasks and problems one after another. Therefore, we have seen major historic victories and achievements. Poor population in rural areas have all been lifted, thus making the great contribution to realize the Xiaokang society. Since the 18th National Congress of CPC, every year, the 10 million more people lifted out of poverty, which equal to the population of a medium-sized country. And the income level for these groups of poor people also significantly improved, and also give priority to our work, to say that the basic living needs of rural poor populations were met, and that such people have access to compulsory education, basic medical services, and housing. And also give a great support and a guarantee to see drinking water. 20 million poor patients also received the classified treatment. The families long troubled by the diseases, now they could straighten their backs. Nearly 20 million people in poverty enjoyed basic living allowance and the poverty alleviation relief. 24 million people in poverty as well as the severely disabled received and enjoyed living and nursing care allowance. 1.1 million people in poverty now became a member of a forest rangers. They protect our lucid water and lush mountains, which also in return give us great access. No matter it's at the snow-covered plateau, Gobi Desert, or caves, or mountainous areas, the sunlight of the poverty alleviation efforts shined in every corner. The destiny of countless people thus changed, and these people's dream could be realized, and their happiness could happen and
realize.
The development pace of social and economic development in impoverished regions were improved in big strides. Thus, we have seen a great changes in their landscapes. The development in these areas have been sped up, and their economic strength have strengthened, and the infrastructure construction also made great advancements. Social undertakings also have seen made great headways. The issues like difficulties in transportation, get access to the drinking waters, the power, telecommunication, education, and medical services have been addressed, and the compulsory education areas for the poor families registered. Right now, we have seen the school dropout rate realize zero in a dynamic state. For the qualified countries, townships, villages right now have the tarmac or cement roads and have the access to bus services and mail services. The newly rebuilt rural roads and also the highway reached 1.1 million kilometers, and new railway mileage was 350,000 kilometers.
The
power supply rate reached 99%. And also for the grid power network, it offers a power accessibility rate of 100% to the rural villages. For the PV and the 4G percentage in the poor villages, the ratio is also above 98%. 7.9 million households with
25.6
million poor villages have received renovation for their dilapidated houses. We have established 35,000 relocation sites,
2.6
million units of relocation houses, 9.6 people are able to remove themselves from their previous areas and they are getting rid of lagging behind and isolation, and these people have been moving into their new homes. Many villages, they no longer need to take the sky bridges, the steel ladders.
苦咸水
they don't need to drink
喝上了清洁水
the salty water, now they're able to get access
告别四面漏风的
to the clean water,
泥草屋
and they no longer need
住上了宽敞明亮的
in the muddy houses,
砖瓦房
they're living in the bright and spacious brick house
千百万贫困家庭的孩子
thousands of millions of
享受到更公平的教育机会
they can provide education to
孩子们
their kids,
告别了天天跋山涉水上学
and cross rivers to go to school,
实现了住学校
to live in their
吃食堂
and they could have meals in
28个人口较少民族
and for the
全部
28 minority groups with fewer population they have shaken off poverty
一些新中国成立后一步跨千年进入社会主义社会的
for some of the
直过民族
Groups,
又实现了从贫穷落后到全面小康的第二次历史性跨越。所有深度贫困地区的最后堡垒被全部攻克，脱贫地区处处呈现山乡巨变、山河锦绣的时代画卷。脱贫群众
For people who have been living
精神面貌焕然一新
poverty, they have refreshed
增添了自立自强的
and they have strengthened their confidence and also they have stronger courage
脱贫攻坚取得了物质上的累累硕果也取得了精神上的累累硕果
and also we have gained a lot of spiritual achievements
广大脱贫群众
For the
激发了奋发向上的精气神
they have higher morale,
社会主义核心价值观得到广泛传播
socialism,
文明新风得到广泛弘扬
the spirit of
艰苦奋斗苦干实干
people are working
用自己的双手创
造
幸福生活的精神在广大贫困地区蔚然成风带领乡亲们历时七年在绝壁上
For a party secretary who has been leading the villages to cut off a road to build a road from the cliff, and it takes him 7 years to build the road.
夏庄村党支部书记毛向林
说 the party secretary 毛向林 from
乡
下庄 village said, if we chisel the mountain and also build the road, and then we are able to build a wider road, even though our generation will suffer from poverty for tens of years, we will bring good life to the next generation.
身残志坚的云南省
and also we have a representative, a villager from
乌龙镇
瓶子村 of 云南
八角庆小组村村民
Mr.
张顺
东
说
Zhang Shundong, he used to say,
我们虽然残疾了
even though we are physically
但我们精神上不残
but we are not mentally disabled,
我们还有脑
we have our mind and we have our hands,
去想去做
we will think, we will do what we can,
贫困群众的精神世界
so
在脱贫攻坚中得到充实
impoverished
和升华
people,
信心更坚，脑子更活，心气儿更足，发生了从内而外的深刻改变。党群干群关系明显改善。
We could see the relations have been significantly improved, which means we have a solid ruling foundation of CPC in rural areas. For party cadres and party members, they respond to the call of CPC Central Committee. They have shown passion and also they are using their actions.
在脱贫攻坚这个没有硝烟的战场上
in the cause of poverty alleviation, they have dedicated themselves and make tremendous achievements.
广大扶贫干部舍小家
For some of the poverty alleviation cadres,
同贫困群众
They bear the spirit to save the public. They treat the poor villages as their relatives who work overtime. They are doing a lot of hard work. When there is a difficulty and there's a critical time, they would like to go to the front line. Now you can see their painstaking efforts is in different places and thousands of households. They have been climbing the highest mountains. They are going through the most dangerous road. They visited the most distant villages and staying in the house of those who are in extreme poverty. Where there is a need, that's where they are. Some villagers said, as long as I'm able to work, I will always serve the villagers. I would like to bring all of the villagers to a better life. He said, I'm a CPC member. I have to lead the others and shake off poverty. The grassroots party organization have been fully leveraged their role while building the party and doing the work of poverty alleviation. They have realized self-development and also we could see a big improvement in the party governance in the rural areas. For the general public in the rural areas, they listen to the guidance of the CPC and followed the guidance of the CPC. They all say CPC member take the lead and we will follow the steps with the CPC member and then we will see hope for poverty alleviation. And they always say we would like to hang the national flag because it is very auspicious. And they also say, don't forget the well diggers when you drink this well. We will not forget CPC for poverty alleviation. Now you can see a big improvement for the relations between the party and the villages. We have created a Chinese model for poverty reduction. We have made great contribution for the global poverty reduction cause. Shaking off poverty, it is a difficult issue that concerning the global development and governance since the reform and opening up. According to the current poverty standard, in China, 770 million rural poor population have been lifted out of poverty. According to the international poverty line set by the World Bank, the population lifted out from poverty in China accounted for 70% of those in the world. And right now, we could see the poverty situation remains severe in the world, and for some countries, there is an intensified division of the rich and the poor. China has delivered the poverty reduction goal that has been set by the UN 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development 10 years in advance. This is widely appraised by the international community. We are working actively to form the International Cooperation on Poverty Reduction. We fulfill our duties and provide what we can to the developing countries. We would like to be a contributor to move along with the poverty reduction in the world. Looking to the past, considering the situation in the world, there's no other country can lift hundreds of millions of people out of poverty in such a short time. This achievement belongs to China, belongs to the world. We also offer our Chinese strengths to build a community of shared future for mankind. In the past 8 years, I hosted 7th Central Poverty Alleviation Conference,
调研
and also I conducted field trip for poverty alleviation for over 50 times. I visited 14 poverty regions
and
looking at the actual situation, making sure that we could offer help to those areas who are in need. I chat with the impoverished people, and actually I could feel the great changes that have been brought by our poverty alleviation endeavor. In different places, I could see the smell from those people who have been lifted up of the poverty. This is the acknowledgement from these residents. And this is also a compliment to the party members and the cadres. And also,
it's also
a good compliment to all the ancestors and the martyrs. Comrades, friends, time makes heroes. Great achievements come from ordinary life. In poverty alleviation work, hundreds and thousands of poverty alleviation cadres have dedicated themselves to their
post.
They work together with the impoverished residents. They spend the time together. They're sacrificing their use and selflessly to the poverty alleviation cause. There are many touching stories in this regard.
For 35
years in a row, we have the new mountain mover, Li Baoguo. So we have someone who dedicated herself into education, lit up the hope for girls who are living in the mountains, Miss Zhang
Guimei.
Also, we have Huang Dafa, who is dedicated himself to use the life to do the
good.
Also, we have someone who are returning to their hometown, Huang Wenxiu. We also have someone who are working at the front line of the poverty alleviation and devote herself into poverty alleviation, Huang Shiyan. And this time, we also see some outstanding individuals and the outstanding collectives who are receiving the honorary titles. And these people are representative of those who have been fought at the front line in poverty alleviation. They always say there are thousands of people in the cause of poverty alleviation. I am just one of them. In the end, if we look at today, even though there are some hardships, but still we feel happy. And some saying that we should not seek for money, we are not seeking for interest, and then the farmers will believe you, and then the farmers will follow our path. And some people are saying, instead of writing an essay, you should pay a visit to those impoverished regions. That's what we need to do. In the fight against poverty, over 1,800 people lost their lives. Their actions showed the original aspiration for CPC members. And for these people who have been lost their lives, they will be remembered in the history. The party and our people will never forget you. China will never forget your contribution. Party committee at different levels and the government should pay attention and show care to the relatives, to those who have lost their lives during poverty alleviation. We have to publicize their touching stories and carry forward their spirits. We have to encourage the members of the public to forge ahead
实现第二个百年奋斗目标，而披肩执锐，勇立新功。
And make greater contribution to realize the second centenary goal.
同志们，
comrades,
朋友们，
friends.
脱贫攻坚取得举世瞩目的成就，
has gained remarkable achievement.
靠的是党的
坚强领导， thanks to the strong leadership of CPC.
靠的是中华民族自力更生艰苦奋斗的精神品质，
nations, featuring self-reliance and hard work.
靠的是新中国成立以来，
thanks to the achievement,
特别是改革开放以来积累的坚实物质基础，
made from reform and opening up, especially the establishment of the new China, and also
一任接着一任干的坚守之多，
came from different generations by generations,
靠的是全党全国各族人民的团结奋斗，
the solidarity and endeavor from the party and the people from all ethnic groups.We have to focus on the national status, understand the pattern for the poverty reduction rules, and we should come out a series of policies and come up with a number of effective policies, working mechanisms, and systems, so that we can follow a path of poverty reduction with Chinese characteristics and form a poverty alleviation theory with Chinese characteristics.
坚持党的领导，
we should stay committed to the leadership of CPC and provide political and organizational guarantee for poverty alleviation.
We should stick
to the a centralized leadership
by
the President Central Committee
and also take总体布局
the poverty alleviation into the advanced integrated plan and the four-pronged comprehensive strategy.
强力推进
and we should make the coordinated plan
我们强化中央统筹
and advance our efforts.
省负总则
we
视线抓落实的工作机制
that the a central government is making the overarching plan
五级书记
and the provincial level
抓扶贫
the a people making the full responsibilities and the county level focusing on the implementation.
我们执行脱贫攻坚一把手负责制。
The secretaries should take the responsibilities.
中西部二十二个省份，党政主要负责同志向中央签署脱贫攻坚证书，立下军令状。脱贫攻坚期内，保持贫困县。
That they will for sure the a stability in the impoverished county during the poverty alleviation period. We also did a great job in building the supporting system, making the a party organization in the a rural area as our center, and also led the people to fight against the poverty. We also organized the a top force.And dispatched this force to the main battlefield. In total, we have dispatched 255,000 working teams stationed in the villages, as well as 3 million first secretaries as well as cadres. 2 million cadres at the village and township level, as well as millions of the village.Cadres worked together on the front line against the poverty, let the party flag fly high over the main battlefield against poverty. Facts have fully proved that the Communist Party of China has incomparable strong leadership organization and executive and should be a reliable leading force to let the people surmount the difficulties and march ahead toward the future. As long as we unwaveringly uphold the leadership of the party, we can and for sure overcome any obstacles in our way toward the goal of meeting people's ever-growing need for a better life.
坚持以人民为中心的发展思想，
We should stick to the people-centered development
philosophy. 坚定不移走共同富裕道。
And we should unwaveringly stick to the common prosperity course.
治国之道，富民为始。
The key to governance a country is to first make its people better off. We always emphasize that people should be our main focus, and we should eradicate poverty, improve people's well-being, and realize common prosperity, which is also essential requirement of socialism. And this is also the key demonstration of our party to make a wholehearted service to our people, and also the key responsibility of our party and the government. We also take people's satisfaction as our KPI merit, and also to allocate our forces to address the basic living needs.
And
we should let the party play its leading role in this regard,
that
we should first give the top priority to the a capital investment in poverty alleviation projects. Over the past 8 years, the a total investment reached 1.6 trillion yuan from central, provincial, and the township level budgetary. The number from the central budgetary reached 660.1 billion. After initiating the fight against poverty, the surplus quotas produced by linking newly added crop-land quotas with the amount of land used for construction to be adjusted inter-provincial reached
440 billion,
that also including circulating funds intra-provincial level, and also the insurance of a small loans reached 710 billion. Green lending totaled 668.8 billion yuan. Financial loans for targeted poverty alleviation were amount to 9.2 trillion yuan.
共享扶贫协作地区投入财政援助和社会帮扶资金
province from the eastern level has invited the a fiscal aid and the social fund reached 100.5 billion to the paired impoverished areas. And the investment made by the companies making contribution to the poverty alleviation process by the eastern sites raised 1 trillion yuan. And we made good use in coordinated manner, uses fiscal tools, and strengthened our supervision on these funds. Make sure that all this money spent to the places where most need it, make sure all these real investment should play its strong role in guarantee the poverty alleviation fund.
Facts fully proved
that in order to do a good job, we should always put the people's fundamental interest as our key focus and starting point. And we should also let the benefit of our reform and development to give to our people in a fair manner. And we should always take people into our heart and also to address the issues bother them one after another, year in, year out. By doing so, we will address people and embark the road of the common prosperity and also reach the substantive progress in this regard.
坚持发展我国社会主义制度,
we firmly stick to
能够集中力量办大事的政治优势,
the political strength of our socialist system, and also form the a common will and actions against poverty. We mobilized the people from party and all walks of life to declare a war against poverty. We worked in one heart and also created that synergy so people from the society as well as the party and the military worked as one team. We emphasize the coordinative help in the poverty alleviation between the eastern and western areas, and also to construct a paired-up initiative, make sure that there's a good flow in the talent, capital, and technology. We also organize a targeted poverty alleviation initiative, and also organize the people from the Party Central Committee as well as the State-owned enterprises, the Democratic Parties, the People's Organizations, and also the armed forces who pitched in. So the different industries also leverage their own strengths to conduct poverty alleviation through industry, technology, education, culture, health, consumption, and the private sectors, the
social
organizations, as well as every individual, organized in a very positive manner. And also, we have seen the campaign of 10,000 companies help 10,000 villages
thrive.
We also organize specific the projects in the poverty alleviation in the different industries, and also let the host authority forces to pitch in, so we can form a greater landscape and covering the different regions and also cross different departments, different companies and units.
So
with all these good wills and also the moves in poverty alleviation, form the and also showcase the great love of the whole society, creating the a force to win the battle against the poverty. The facts approved
that the
leadership of the Communist Party of China and our socialist system actually the fundamental guarantee for us to fend off the risks and challenges and overcome obstacles. Only way stick to the party's leadership and stick to the A path with a socialist with Chinese characteristics, can we complete the A greater cause and undertaking like quality and leadership endeavors, and also gaining the victory from one another.
And
the precision poverty alleviation strategy is our focus. We believe the way out is to eradicate poverty through the targeted manner. We have emphasized many times that the poverty alleviation should focus on the targeted manners. Therefore, we have conducted a meticulous management style for DA resources that are also in a targeted manner in terms of allocation, and for DA objectives and DA personnel, that also we have the detailed management, and also established nationwide registration systems, make sure that the resources really benefited and helped the people waiting for those help, and also to channel all these resources to the impoverished areas. Regarding the issues and who should receive the help and who should give the help and how, and also how to withdraw this poverty alleviation list, and we have also launched a set of policies. Make sure all these policies should be tailored. And we also look at the cause of baking people in the poverty, and also look at what kind of solution we can take in order to give that the targeted treatment to these poverty bothered places to make sure the root cause addressed. Of course, all these measures time required. We should make sure all our efforts should go to the exact places that we want to help in terms of the household and also the poverty alleviation areas. Make sure we're not just for the sake of the average numbers, and we should focus on the big majorities. We have always stick to the development style poverty alleviation plan. Make sure that we should deal with the poverty through development, make sure that we also can shift our DA poverty alleviation method from giving the fish to milking the fish by themselves. And we also seek the most effective way so people can enjoy a better life in a sustainable manner. Therefore, education is the key issue. Focusing that we should not let our kids bothered because of the poverty, and we should not let our kids lose at the starting line and make every endeavor that they can shine themselves in their life and to suffer the poverty passing on from one generation to another.
Realize economic and social development and improving people's well-being and deal with the imbalanced and inadequate problem. We should insist the mobilizing our whole society, especially people in the impoverished region, so they can create their own power to help themselves out of poverty. We talk about that how to make people out of poverty, they should rely on themselves. So they first need to realize their
mindsets.
We always focus on transferring people's needs to living a better life to the real actions. So we talk about the poverty alleviation. So we help them not to really get, help them get rich, but also let them reach in their
mindset.
So people can rely on their own efforts and their perseverance to help them out of poverty and change their destiny. We guide the people in poverty the concept that as long as they work hard, they will see the results. And encourage them that as long as they have confidence, the yellow sands could transfer and change to gold, and also strengthen their resilience, that they should have that encourage, motivation, and bring that into their real actions. People already out of poverty said that now we have the preferential policies from the country, that we will not wait and see, because we know that we could make that things change and make things happen. The life changed us, and we also change our own life. Facts also fully prove that the people is to be a real hero. Encourage people to find their potential and make it a hard work to bring that as the self-generated power to drive them on the embark of the greater life. As long as we insist the people-centered philosophy, rely on our people and respect our people, and let them play the role of the pioneering, we believe we will find out and unleash their potential and also utilize their business and strength. We will create many incredible miracles.
We should stay committed
to carry forward the traditional nature that features solidarity and mutual support.
We will promote
the whole society to exercise the core value of the socialism, to carry forward the traditional virtue of Chinese nation featuring mutual support, solidarity, and help those who are in need. And we will also guide the society to show care to the poor residents, pay attention to the poverty reduction cause, and dedicate ourselves in the poverty alleviation. We have to improve the mobilization mechanism, set up the participation platform, and bring innovation to the assistance, making sure that people would like to engage in poverty alleviation and make their own contribution. Facts show the core value of socialism and the traditional virtue of Chinese nation can help to concentrate our thoughts and form cohesion of our people. We have to be determined and follow this path and unlock the positive energy from the society so that we can exert strength for the Chinese nation to break away and forge ahead. We should be pragmatic and always seek the truth, making sure that we can provide support to areas with extreme poverty. We have to strictly govern the party and also this will be going throughout the poverty alleviation procedures. We have to show our efforts and our spirit, making sure that we do all our best for the poverty alleviation. We have to follow a concrete guidance, and we should cut off all the red tapes, and we will do concrete work, and we will reject to exaggeration. We should oppose to all kinds of formality projects, reject formalities, bureaucracy, making sure that all the work we have been done can solve the practical problems of the poor residents. We will exercise the most strict evaluation and assessment, and we will also crack down the corruption and other misconduct behaviors. We will set up a supervision system in all aspects, making sure that the poverty alleviation achievement can stand the test of history and of the people. Facts show arrangement or deployment accounts for 10%, implementation accounts for 90%. We have to do concrete work to ensure the victory for the battle of poverty alleviation. We have to stay committed for solid work so that solid work can benefit our country, can benefit our people. And then we are able to build China into a modern socialist country. All of these important experiences is the essence for poverty alleviation in China. It also shows the latest achievement of China under Marxism poverty reduction theory. We have to abide by these theories and continue to develop this theory. Comrades,
朋友们,
friends,
伟大事业,
great cause,
nurtures
great spirit.
伟大精神,
great spirit
lead
the great cause.
脱贫攻坚伟大斗争,
for the battle against poverty, has come up a poverty alleviation spirit
进锐出战,
featuring solidarity,
精准务实,
innovation,
开拓,
dedication,
创新, 攻坚克难,
and also it features a sense of mission for all our people.
的脱贫攻坚精神,
脱贫攻坚精神,
for this
poverty alleviation spirit. For this poverty alleviation spirit, also shows the mission of the Communist Party of China, also shows the fine character of Chinese people, and also shows the spirit of Chinese nation. This spirit is also a demonstration of patriotism, collectivism, and also the socialist ideology. And this also shows the Chinese spirit, Chinese value, and the Chinese strength. This also carried forward the great Chinese nation and the spirit of the era.
全国,
all party,
全社会,
all country, all the society should carry forward the spirit for poverty alleviation.
团结一心,
we have to stay
英勇奋斗,
united, fight courageously,
坚决战胜,
be decisive to conquer all the difficulties
lying
ahead of us,
坚持和发展,
and we should strive for greater success.
新的,
in socialism with Chinese characteristics. Comrades, friends, the complete victory for poverty alleviation marks that with the leadership of CPC,
创造美好生活,
we have made a greater contribution to lead our people to create a better life and realize common prosperity.
脱贫摘帽,
at the same time,
不是终点,
poverty eradication is not the end. Instead, it is a starting point for new life and new endeavor.
解决发展不平衡不充分问题,
we have to resolve the problem for
缩小城乡区域发展差距,
development, unbalanced development,
实现人的,
we have to shorten the gap between the urban and the rural areas,
仍然,
and also we still have a long way ahead of us to realize overall development for mankind and seek common prosperity.
松劲,
we should not be proud and we should not slacken our efforts. We have to work harder and make greater achievements.
胜非其难也,
it is not difficult to gain victory, but it is difficult to hold on to the achievement. We have to consolidate the achievement we have been made from poverty alleviation, and also we have to work on rural revitalization, making sure that we have a solid foundation for poverty alleviation, and then the effectiveness could sustain. To the vulnerable groups, especially people may fall back to poverty, we have to strengthen our monitoring and supervision, making sure that we can early identify these people, and then we can do early intervention and provide support when necessary.
For
regions that has been lifting up from poverty, we have to provide support to the industrial development so that we can form a self-driven development. For residents who have been lifting up from poverty through relocation, we will provide follow-up support to these people. We should encourage them to find a job, and we should do what we can to improve the employment. We will strengthen the social governance, and also making sure that these residents can integrate to the new environment. And also, we will provide support to those counties who have been removed the cap for poverty. We should set up a transitional period, making sure that all of these policy remain stable. We continue to set up the secretaries and the working teams in the villages, strengthen the coordination between the East and the West, provide the caring services, and improve the social mechanisms to provide support to the impoverished regions. When necessary, we will improve all of these supports. 党中央决定 according to the actual situation, the CPC Central Committee has decided that when necessary, we will roll out the assessment and evaluation work of poverty alleviation. We should clarify the responsibilities to all localities and the party committees, making sure that there will not be a large scale of people going back to poverty. Rural revitalization is a major mission to realize the rejuvenation of Chinese nation. We have to focus on the new development stage, implement the new development philosophy, and we will analyze the new situation brought by the new landscape, and we have to focus on the three rural issues. This is the top priority for the party. We have to prioritize the development of the rural areas and the villages, and we will follow the path of rural revitalization with Chinese characteristics. We have to shorten the gap between the development of the urban and the rural areas, making sure that the low-income population and underdeveloped regions can share the dividends of the development, so that these low-income population and underdeveloped regions can catch up with the others. To roll out the rural revitalization is as difficult as the poverty alleviation. We have to improve our policy system, working mechanism, our systems. We need to provide stronger measures to gather more strength, accelerate the modernization of the rural areas and the villages, promote high quality development for the agriculture areas, making sure that people can stay in the villages comfortable, and then the farmers can achieve prosperity. In our journey to build a modern socialist country, we have to put common prosperity for all people as our priority. We need to do concrete work and work relentlessly. We should fight towards this target. And we have to promote the overall development of humans and boost the progress for the social development. We need to improve people's sense of gaining, sense of happiness, and also the sense of security, making sure that they feel secure, and all of these efforts can be sustained. Comrades, friends, reviewing the past, we have made tremendous achievement in eradicating absolute poverty that troubled the Chinese nation for thousands of years. We have created a miracle of poverty reduction in human history. Looking to the future, we are working to build a modern socialist country.
征途漫漫,
we have a long journey.
唯有奋斗,
we have to keep up with our work.
全党全国,
all party,
各族人民,
people from different ethnic groups have to rally closer around CPC Central Committee.
坚定,
we have to firm up our confidence,
以永不懈怠的精神状态,
work relentlessly,
一往无前的奋斗姿态,
march
真抓实干,
forward courageously,
埋头苦干,
dedicated ourselves
向着实现,
to achieve
第二个,
the goal
百年奋斗目标,
for the second
奋勇前进,
goal.
同志们，刚才习近平总书记发表了重要讲话，庄严宣告了脱贫攻坚战取得全面胜利，从全面建成小康社会，实现第一个百年奋斗目标的战略高度，充分肯定了
Great outcomes on poverty elimination, comprehensively revealed the glory journey and summarized the valuable experience along that journey, and elaborated the noble spirit of the poverty alleviation, and also raised the requirement on comprehensively advancing rural revitalization and consolidation of poverty alleviation.General Secretary Xi's speech was strong importance in terms of the political, ideological, the strategic and the target manner, calling everyone to study in details and implement into its letters. Let us rally closer with the Party Central Committee with Comrade Xi Jinping at its core, a guide by the Xi Jinping thought on socialism with Chinese characteristics for a new era, strengthen four consciousness of the need, stay firm to four confidence, to uphold, and also to upgrade our a judgment and capacity, carry forward in a spirit, and work together to fight tenaciously.
And also to celebrate and the 100-year
of the founding of the party and the building the modern social country and work together to realize the Chinese dream of the national rejuvenation. The National Commandment Conference on Poverty Alleviation now concludes.